Hello everyone, myself Twinkle Patel from MGTown outside. This video lecture is about Python sets. So in this video lecture we will cover introduction to sets, how to access the item in set, len function, how to add and remove the item in sets, how to join two sets, is disjoint method in the set and intersection method in the set. So first of all we will introduce set. So first of all, set is a collection data type in Python. So it is a collection type which is unordered and unindexed. So in Python, sets are written with curly braces and no duplicate members are allowed in the set. So this is an example of one set. Set name is fruits, which is enclosed with the curly braces, which contain banana, mango and cherry, three elements in the sets. After that, we have printed our set. So set is a collection which is unordered and unindexed and written with the curly brackets. Next we will see how to access the item in the set. So as we have mentioned that set is unordered and unindexed. So we cannot access the item in a set by referring to an index. As previously we have discussed in the dictionary that dictionary has a key value pair. So using the key value we can access the elements in the dictionary. In list and the tuple, using the index value we can access the all the elements in the list and the dictionary. But here set is unordered, so we cannot refer it by using the index. So we have to look for the sets to access the item in a set. So here is an example. So to access the elements of the fruits, we have to look through it for x in fruits. Fruits is our set. After that, we have printed the elements of the set. So all the elements of the sets are printed. Next, we will see the len function. So to determine how many elements are available in the set, len function is used. So len, after that, set name. So it will return 6 because our set contains total 6 elements. Next is how to add the item in a set. To add one item to a set, we use the add method. And to add more than one item in a set, update method is used. So here, consider our example, we have a set named fruits. Now, if you want to add orange to our set, we will use the add method because only one item we want to add. So write down the fruits.addOrange. So orange is added to the set here. After that, if you want to add more than one item, then we have to write down as a fruits.update. And after that, in the square bracket, we have to write down the total number of elements we want to add. Here we want to add apple and kiwi. So fruits.update, parenthesis, then curly bracket and the elements we want to add, right? So next we will print our set. So apple and here kiwi, two elements are added in our set. Next is how to remove the item in the sets. So there are several methods which is used to remove the item in the set. First is remove method and another is discard method. So fruits.removeOrange will remove the orange from the set. So next print statement set has orange is not included in the set. Next, another method is discard. Discard is the same as removed. So discard is also remove the kiwi from the our set. But the only difference between the remove and discard is that if the item we want to remove doesn't exist in the set, then remove will raise an error. But if the item we want to remove doesn't exist in the discard method, then discard will not raise an error and it will do nothing. Next method is we can use the pop method to remove an item. So fruits.pop. So the return value of the pop will remove from the set. So as we know that the sets are unordered, so we cannot say that this is the last item or first item. So the return value of the pop method is removed from the set. So here banana is removed from the fruit set. Next is clear method. So clear method empties the set. So Here, our set contains mango, apple, and cherry. After that, using the clear method, we will remain with the empty set, which is printed here. Another method which is used to remove the item from the set is del keyword. So, del keyword also delete the set. Del keyword will delete the set completely. So, here the example, del fruits. Fruits is our set name. After that, if we try to print our set, then Python will raise an error such as name fruits is not defined. So, to clear the data of our set, we will use the clear method, and to delete the set completely, we will use the del keyword. Next, we will see how to join the two sets. For that, two methods is used. Union method that return the new set containing the all item from the both the set. And next one is update method that insert all the items from one set into the another. For example, see here, and both the method will exclude the duplicate item. Right? So see here, example, our set 1 containing 1, 2, 3, set 2 containing ABC. Now, using the union method, we can generate the set 3. So set 3 equal to set 1 dot union set 2. So now set 3 contains the elements of set 1 as well as set 2. Now, if we want to update our set 2 with the element of set 1, then we will write down set 2 dot update set 1. So set 2 is updated and element of set 1 are added into set 2. Therefore, set 2 will now contain elements of set 2 as well as set 1. Next is disjoint method in sets. So is disjoint method return true if none of the common items are present in both the sets, otherwise it return false. So consider here example, set 1 contain 1, 2, 3, set 2 contain 5, 6, 7. As we can see here that both the sets doesn't have any common items. So z equal to set 1 dot is disjoint set 2 will return true because both the sets are disjoint to each other. Next is intersection method. So the intersection method returns a set that contains the similarity between two or more sets, that is the common elements between the two sets. So see here example, S1 contain apple, banana and cherry, and S2 contain Google, Microsoft and Apple. Now we are going to intersect H1 dot intersection S2, which will return the another set, that is S3. Now the common elements between S1 and S2 is apple. So S3 set contain the apple element. So we have discussed some of the important method of the set and how to remove and add items from the set. This is all about sets, introduction to sets. Thank you.